Yeah, good morning, everyone. It's a great privilege to introduce myself. Before entering into the topic, welcome you all for the one-day program of webinar on LaTeX. Right, Ekalavya Group of Technologies established in the year 2019 with a prime motto of importing quality education in engineering. From establishing a small institute with just a handful of students in the year 2019 in Tirupati, the institute has grown by leaps and bounds and established itself as one of the leading institute in AP. Ekalavya Group of Technologies can handle academic projects related to various technologies for different disciplines like undergraduate and postgraduation. Ekalavya Group of Technologies has been implementing and developing innovative projects in engineering by providing complete explanation and information. Ekalavya Group of Technologies provides innovative engineering skill development solutions for engineering students and who are interested to learn advanced technologies in various domains like VLSI, embedded systems, Internet of Things, Python and Java. I hereby welcome our guest, Dr. Om Prakash Yadav, sir. Welcome you, sir. Dr. Om Prakash Yadav sir is working as an associate professor in the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering from Pace Institute of Technology and Management, Shimoga, Karnataka. He obtained his PhD from CSVTU Bhilai, M.Tech from NIT Raipur and BE from MPCT Gwalior. He is having around 16 years of teaching experience. He has published more than 20 papers in international and national journals and more than 25 papers in international and national conferences. He is life member of ISTE and IE India. Thank you, sir. I hereby hand over the session to the Dr. Om Prakash Yadav, sir. Please continue the session, sir.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Club Group of Technologies, for giving me, for providing me this opportunity to interact with the faculty, the students, and you know, research scholars. So before starting my talk, I would like to congratulate Ekalavya Group of Technologies for expanding their wings in all the directions, and you know, within a year they have achieved so much of success. So best wishes to Ekalavya Group of Technologies. And at the same time, I'm also thankful to Ekalavya Group of Technologies and the Institute of India, Kadapa Local Center, for giving me this opportunity to share my knowledge over LaTeX. So let me start with the LaTeX now.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you for giving the your opportunity also.
Yeah. So LaTeX is, it's a platform where we can write our, we can create our documents. It is similar to Word. So in my today's talk, we'll be discussing what is actually LaTeX and how it is different from Word processor, and what are the advantages of using this LaTeX platform, and how we can install LaTeX, and how we can create simple simple documents to thesis also we can create using LaTeX software. And finally, at the end, I will give one demo of suppose we are not completely unaware of LaTeX and we have to create any document in LaTeX. So my final session will be on Overleaf, that is online tool in which we can create a LaTeX document in a very systematic and easy way. So let me share the screen now. So let me start with the LaTeX. So LaTeX is a high quality typesetting platform. Typesetting in the sense it is similar to word processor. And it is developed for the production of technical and scientific documentation. I mean to say that we can create academic documents with the help of LaTeX. And the best part of this LaTeX software is that it is a free software. You can download and install free of cost. It is free of cost. And some of the academicians, they are having some misconception that LaTeX is a word processor. So let me clear you that LaTeX is not a word processor. It is entirely different, and somewhat it is difficult to understand. But once you are familiar with the LaTeX, it will be more easy as compared to Word document. Now LaTeX, for the LaTeX, you need not to worry too much about the appearance. It will LaTeX software itself, it will take care of appearance of your document. But you have to concentrate on getting the contents, means you have to focus more over the content rather than on the appearance of the document. Now moving further, let me tell you what are the advantages of using LaTeX as compared to word processors. So in case of LaTeX, the quality of document which you will be getting will be of a high typeset quality. It means a standard on document output you can expect. And even it is very difficult to write equations with in word processor, but it is very easy to handle equations in LaTeX. Source file format is not bounded to a particular operating system or platform. This is again one of the greatest advantages of using LaTeX. And even you can implement LaTeX on all platforms, whether it is DOS, Windows or Unix, etc. So in short, LaTeX and word processor, since we are using from the beginning, we are using word processor, so we are thinking that we are much more compatible with the Word. But let me assure you that once you please use LaTeX, then it will become more easy to use LaTeX as compared to word processor. Now coming back to installation, so let me move to the installation process. So installation means how you can install LaTeX in your system. So one link I have given in my PPT, from that link, although so many sources from so many online links you can download, but this is the easiest, and through this you can understand, you can understand also how we have to install. So that link I have given. So even in Google also you can search that how to install LaTeX. So when MikTeX file will be open. So from that file only I have taken this document. So here you can see that getting MikTeX. Now before downloading, you should please check the prerequisites for the LaTeX which you are going to install. So suppose you are going to install for Windows, so which Windows you are using, which operating system you are using. So depending upon your operating system and you have to select. So here once you have chosen the you have checked your system requirement, then you can go to the download. And in download you have just checked that whether your system is compatible to support LaTeX or not. Then here once you just scroll down, then here you can see Windows. So in Windows so many installations are there. Even you can see all the downloads, you can move to all downloads. There you can see which installer you are going to install. Like if your system is 64-bit, you have to install this one. If your system is 32-bit, here net installer, if you want to install through net, you can go for this one. MikTeX setup utility is also there. So depending upon your system, you can download. But my suggestion is that just go to Windows. If you are using Windows, then go to download. So once you have downloaded this, depending upon, please, I am saying that if you are using 64, you have to download the 64-bit MikTeX. Otherwise, your system will not respond to that particular software. So once you have downloaded, so this particular MikTeX is for 64-bit. From here itself you can check. So please download it, and after download please go to the tutorial section. Here you can find the process of installing the MikTeX. we are going to install LaTeX from Miktex a website. Now we have already seen, so once you have downloaded the software, then you can go for then you have to run that software. So once you run that software, this type of window will appear here. You have to accept the Miktex copying conditions, then you will be asked to go to next, go to the next, then it will ask you to set up a private text installation or system wide text installation. My suggestion is to go for a private text installation, because it will be with you and there will not be any complication. Suppose you are using your system personally, then it is better to go for private text installation. Once this installation, then it will ask where you want to install. So you have to provide the directory for installation process. So select the directory where you want to install. You can install in any as per your convenience. After that, one important thing it will ask that the wizard allow you to set up the preferred page size. So here we select A4. If it is not, by default it will be A4, but if it is not, then please select A4 and initial missing packages on the fly. So ask me first. So what is the disadvantage of using suppose you have not focused over this one, then all the packages will be installed and it will consume so much of your space. So my suggestion is that you just select here, ask me first. So if any of the package in your LaTeX is missing, it will first ask you to ask your permission. If you allow, then only it will install, otherwise it will not install. So but if you have selected that install all the packages directly, then what will happen? Suppose in your document any package is missing, it will automatically automatically installed, and it will consume so much of the space of your system, and it will make your system slow. So my suggestion is that please select, ask me first. Once it is selected, then installation process is almost completed, then you can close this window. So once the installation process is completed, you are ready with the Miktex software. So LaTeX is installed. Now LaTeX software is installed, but you need one editor where you can write your programs and you can run the programs. So there are so many editors available that supports LaTeX. So like TextMaker, TextSync Center, Lex, TextStudio, TextWorks, Overleaf. So these depending upon your system compatibility, you can install any of the editors. So editors are something where we can write our programs. Our text we have to enter here only. Here we have to enter our text and then it will be converted. So here again I have given one link for the same. So this you can 10 best LaTeX editors you can use. So editors are nothing but they are actually a platform where we will put our documents. Like in Word, suppose you have opened the Microsoft Word and you used to write simply. For LaTeX also, this editor is required. So editor is the editor where we will write our programs, write our documents. So many document editors are available, like TextMaker and Lex already I said you. So we can use. So depending upon, please again here you have to focus that you have to check which that editor is compatible with your system. So many editors are available, and here this small program written in LaTeX, we will check it later on. So these are the editors. So once you have the editor, now your installation is complete. You are ready with the LaTeX software and you can even write your script, create your document. So it will be something there will be a shortcut like this one. Here you can see a TextMaker. I have used TextMaker editor. So a shortcut like this will be opened. It will be created on your desktop. So once shortcut is created, you can open and you can write your programs. So let us have a brief look on some of the important things, and then I will take you to the text maker. So what are the contents of LaTeX documents? So all the LaTeX documents will have an extension of .tex. So if we are creating any document in LaTeX, that has to be saved with an extension of .tex. So this is our input. And now in order to execute these documents, there will be some of them, you may use some of the packages. The packages are similar to header files, which we have used in earlier, or toolboxes in MATLAB. So packages are similar to that only. So there are special packages, and their task is already defined. For what purpose they are meant for. So that is already defined. So accordingly, we have to use packages. So if your package is missing, then it will ask you first to install. It will ask for your permission before installation. That I was saying during installation process. Now document classes, there you have to define which type of document you are going to create. And finally, at the end of all documents, you'll be having a bibliography. So another file is to be created, like a bibliography or a BIB file. Sometimes it is abbreviated as a BIB. And some of the auxiliary files, it will be automatically created. And if it is not there, then you have to provide that. So already, some of the auxiliary files are already there with the templates, of a standard journal. So you can either directly download, or if you are expert of LaTeX, you can create these files also. Finally, at the output, you can see output in the form of PDF or PostScript document or screen or printer, depending upon the way you want to visualize your output, you can see. So in short, a LaTeX document, for LaTeX document, you have to have one .tex file. Then there will be a class which you have to define, packages depending upon your document, you have to use packages, and bibliography, again you have to create, and if there are other supporting files also, you have to use. So this is in short, we have to club all these files together so as to get our output. Now coming to the basic document structure. So as I said you that the all the LaTeX files are having a .tex extension. So before running or executing any of the text file, you have to save it with any name .tex extension. Now if we talk about the format of a document is pretty simple. In that we have there will be a preamble, and then front matter in the body, and the back matter. Like any of the articles, like article will be having preamble, front body, front matter, then body, and the bibliography. So in the preamble, we have to specify the document and packages we are going to use. In the front matter, title, author, date, all those things, initial things we have to provide, and in the body, main content is to be there. And in the back matter, bibliography is to be there. So these things we have to write in the editor, and the editor which I was talking, you can have n number of editors. There are actually more than 10 number of editors. You can use any of the editor to write your document. So now coming back to the preamble, here you have to specify the document class, like which type of article you are going to create, whether it is a letter style or article, or whether it is a report, book, slides, etc. So the very first line you have to mention is this one only. backslash is used at the beginning of text markup command everywhere. So document class point, we are going to use the 12-point font, so 0.4, and the type of class we are going to use article. So depending upon the type of document, you can choose here or change here whether it is a letter, article, report, book, slides, or etc. There are n number of packages available. Like, you know, if you want to write equations, there will be a different separate package. If you want to use, you know, color figures, there will be a separate package. If you want to use tables in a different style, again you have to use a different package. So there are so many packages, and at the beginning itself you have to define all those packages. Like here, you know, some packages are mentioned, like slash backslash use a package margin geometry. So this package is mainly meant to set the margin of the document. Then use package, you know, set space is to provide or is to set the space between the characters. Use package hardware for it is for bibliography purpose. So if any of the package is missing in your document, any of means, suppose you want to create one document and that will have figure. So if figure package, a package related to figure is missing, then in that case your document will not be able to produce the desired output, and there will be some error. So you have to install the packages, and you have to take care of all these packages before going for the final execution. Now coming back to the front method. So in the front method, your document will restart, like begin, end. So everywhere you can see that backslash will be there. Then wherever there is a begin, there must be some end. So please remember that begin, always begin. And like we have seen for end, as in the case of MATLAB, and if else, like everywhere. So wherever there is a begin, you have to take care that it must be somewhere, and somewhere in the document there must be end also. So here it is begin document. So finally at the end there should be backslash end document. Now here you can mention title, author, make title, and then begin abstract, end abstract, like that. This is for this is to change. This is to provide a page break or change the page. So all these are front matter. Now coming to the body of the text. So in the body of the text, we can have sections, subsections, sub-subsections. Accordingly, there it will automatically perform the numbering. If we don't want numbering in our section, we have to use this syntax. Otherwise, suppose we have written a backslash section introduction. So here it will come as 1 point, and here it will be introduction. Now suppose we have used backslash subsection abstract. So it will be referred as 1.1 abstract, like that. Now appendix, accordingly you can have appendix and backslash chapter. It will indicate as a chapter for thesis and dissertations. Likewise, we have emphasize, and if you want our a particular text to be bold, then we can use backslash text bf, then for to provide a spacing between the lines. If you want single spacing, then we have to use this command before the that paragraph. And if you want double spacing, then you have to use this command, 1.5 spacing mostly, which is required in the document. So for 1.5, this command is to be used. So all these commands suppose if you are beginner, it seems difficult, but once you are familiar with the LaTeX, it will become very easy, and all these commands are available on on a single click. You can just type in Google, you'll get the syntax related to that one. Now suppose you want keep some document in the center, you have to use begin centering, or you can use begin centering and end centering. Wherever, please remember, wherever there is begin, there must be end. So this is all about the body. And then sometimes in your document you want to provide footnotes, quotes, or equations. So for footnote, the syntax is like backslash footnote, and whatever you want to write, you have to mention here. Then begin quote and end quote, so whatever will be there, it will be mentioned here. So whatever you want to provide, you can mention here. Similarly, for mathematical equations, you have to use either you can use in inline mode. Inline mode means within these dollar symbols, whatever is written, it will be in the mathematical form. Or alternatively, you can use this begin command, begin equation and end equation, and whatever is written in between, that will be in the form of equation. For example, see here, mass always in between this dollar symbols. Here you can see. So suppose here some text is written that this is our first equation, and then dollar 1 + 4 = 5. So it will appear as 1 + 4 = 5 in the text in the form of mathematics. Here you can see some of the syntax for equations, like fraction is for x y upon y upon x upon y format, and this is for a square root, this is for summation k is equal to 1 to n. At this moment it may be difficult to understand, but once you are comfortable with this one, it will become very easy. And frankly speaking, and the document will be much more pleasant as compared to the word if you are using this. Similarly, for special symbols like alpha and beta, you can use the syntax which is already given in the LaTeX software. Now, creating a table is also very simple. So here we have to define a table, and then we have to end a table. So in between the table, we have to provide rows and columns. So this is the syntax. Every table is associated with the caption. So caption will be there. You can write the caption, and by default it will be on the top of the table. And then a label, we have to provide the label so that we can refer that label in our text also. So as compared to Word, this here it seems difficult, but the output of this table will be much more pleasant as compared to the table which you have created in your Word. So this is very simple. You can see this is left aligned, this is centrally aligned, and this one is right aligned. And here you have three columns. So accordingly, we are having three columns, but here three columns, and they are separated by AND symbols. So I will see, and I will see an example. So whatever is written here, if begin, end. So I will see how we can create tables and how beautifully it appears in our document. Similar is the case with the figures also. So for figures, we have to use a special package that is I use package graphics. It is meant for figures. So for figures also, a begin figure, and then we have to provide end figure, and then include graphics. Then we can change the dimension of the figure, and then that image, where is that image? So we have to provide that image. Here is the image, and then caption and label. By default, caption will be on the downward only. In the bottom of the figure, and label is to use that label in the text. For example, here figure reference, so backslash reference figure one. So wherever is that figure, suppose the figure of this figure is 10, so here automatically it will come as figure 10, shows the boat. Now sometimes what happens, we want our figure to be on the top, or to be on the bottom of the page, or on an extra page, or we want it at a particular location or same location. So depending upon your requirement, here we have to change. Here we have to mention begin figure, and here if we have written in these curly brackets S, then it will be in the same location. Or if we have written here T, then it will be on the top of that particular page. And suppose we want that on the bottom of the page, then here we have to mention B. So that is all about how we can create figures using Latex. Now coming to the some common mistakes, as I told you that often we make mistakes while creating a document. What kind of mistake we are doing? As I told you, every begin it has to be followed by end, and if dollar symbol is there, then it has to be again terminated in the text. Then only you'll not be getting error. Otherwise, you'll be getting error. It is similar to your program. Word is not a program. Whatever error is there, you can directly see. But here we have to compile and then we have to see whether there is error or not. So that is somewhat, you know, it seems difficult, but it is not at all difficult. Sometimes you forget to put this one, so this is again create a problem for you. Now let me tell you one example how we can use. So suppose I want to create a paper in IEEE format. So I am starting from the beginning. Go to the Google, and then here you can type IEEE LaTeX format, IEEE LaTeX template. Although I have already downloaded, but let me tell you how you can start if you are just a beginner. So here the template is there. IEEE template selector. This is not this clip. Let me open the first one itself. So here you can see IEEE conference template is there. Here you have to download this one, and this bibliography files you can download. So once you have downloaded the template, unzip, it is in the zip format, unzip. So I unzipped all the documents, and here is the all unzipped documents. You can see clearly nothing I have done here. Simply I have downloaded the IEEE format and then kept in a particular folder named IEEE. Now I want to use this. I want to create one IEEE document using LaTeX. So let me open the text maker. So it is there. Then go to file. This will be the, let me tell you, this will be the structure of all the editors, LaTeX editors. Here we used to write our document, and here we can see the structure of the document. The S refers to section, and then there sub sections. So here we can see the structure of the documents, and then what are the tools available. Various tools are available with this LaTeX software. So don't worry, it will become if we are using this, then you will become comfortable with this one. If you see LaTeX, if you want to create section, chapter, subsection, subchapter, simply just we have to click only, it will appear. Then if you want our document to be in center or left aligned or right aligned, or we want to put something, then you have to click here. Is similarly for spacing. If you want new page, you can create here line break, page break, big skip. So all these things are available. You have to just study. So I was discussing about the IEEE template. So suppose let me start with the beginning. You are completely new to the LaTeX, and you have downloaded the LaTeX, installed the editor, and now you have downloaded the IEEE format. You have kept all the IEEE format in a folder, and that is named as IEEE. Now move to the file and open the that particular TEC file. Please remember, you have to open the TEC file. So here is the TEC file which I have opened. Now this is the TEC file which is already there. Simply what I did, I have not I don't have any basic knowledge of LaTeX. I am going to use I am going to create one paper in IEEE format. Now here you can see some of the symbols like quick build and view PDF. If you want other outputs, then you have to click here. Otherwise, view PDF only, quick build. I have not even I simply copied the document. That's all. Nothing is done from my side. Then let me run. So if you will run, it will the document in the PDF format will appear. So this is the template which I have downloaded, and I want to create my own paper in this template. So just see where you want to make changes. So here from conference paper title is mentioned. So here see where is that without changing any other packages, like here you can see a document class IEEE transaction, it is mentioned. Don't change this one. He has used so many packages, like a site package they have used for citation purpose, use package AMS maths for writing equations, logarithmic package to algorithmic package for writing algorithms, graphics for images like that, and to input color to figures. So many packages they have used. We don't have to change anything except where we want to change. Like suppose I want to change this conference paper title. So just go to where they have mentioned the conference paper title. So here I found the same. So here let me change this one and let us see whether it will work or not. This is our first document. Again, now let us run and see whether it is coming or not. So see, the only that is reflected. So likewise, we can change. Let me remove the star, and suppose I want to change. So by going through these already available, already available, templates, we can learn. So it is not difficult, but you have to spend some time. For example, suppose now I want to change the author's name also. So let us see where is the author name mentioned. So here, first given name, surname is mentioned. Let us see where is the first given name and surname. So here, see, first given name and surname. I want to change this one. So here, first is there. I want to change this given name, surname. So let me change here, given name, surname. First is there. I want to change the affiliation also. Quickly do. See, so here my name is there and department of EEE, and likewise you can change wherever you want to change. Now suppose you have something, you have already prepared the paper and you want to change the abstract. So what you can do, you can just copy the abstract where you have written. Let me open one document. Yes. Let me open one of my document only. Now I want, let me copy this one. This is going to be my abstract. So let us check whether it is working or not. So see, abstract is completely changed and I have written. So likewise, you can use already existing templates to create your own paper, and it is not so, it will not take so much of it will not consume so much of time. It will be done within fraction of within minutes. So likewise, if you want to write equations also, you can write equations. So let me tell you how to write equations in this section. So here, you know, see section, they have written as a section. I want to create one subsection here itself. So just what I have to do, I have to write here / subsection. It will automatically come. Subsection. Let me write as a second section. So it will automatically, it will be reflected there. See a second section. This is as per the IEEE format. Now suppose I want to write equation. So let us see, let us write here equation. I want to add one equation here. So for equation, you have to study actually, because you know, it is not as simple as, you know, we are using in Word. Begin equation, simply begin equation. See, begin equation, x is equal to a simple equation y plus 2. Now let me run the equation. So see, x is equal to y plus 2. It is how nicely it is represented in, you know, a LaTeX document. You can see here, and the number is already provided by this equation itself. Now suppose I want to use this equation in my text also. So let me write label. Equation 1. Now I want to use that equation here. So this is my equation plus REF. REF is to call that equation 1. So it is already open. So see this equation, it will come here. Sometimes you need to run 2-3 times in order to get the result. See here, this is my first equation, and it is whatever number it will come here, the same will be reflected here. You need not to worry. Now the same text, same equation you want to write in the text, as I told you, you have to use dollar symbol. So here is the dollar symbol, and the same equation I want to write in my text also. So same equation is written here in the text also. So depending upon your use, you can change. Now this is how, you know, equations are written, and you know, if you want special symbols, you can use these you know, symbols in your document. Wherever you want to use, you can use. Just suppose you want to use alpha in this expression here, just click here and select this one, alpha will appear, and if you run, that will be that will appear across in the equation itself. So see here, x is equal to y plus 2 alpha, it is now coming. So likewise, you know, if you spend some time over this LaTeX software, it will become very easy to, you know, write the equations, and appearance will also be very, you know, pleasant. Now let me write second equation, that x1 is equal to, here I want to write, you know, I want to write let's see. Let me write x1 is equal to x square plus 2. That's all. This is going to be my equation number 2. Label I have given. I have not given any equation numbering, but label I have given so as to, you know, keep the labels in my documents. And reference equation 2. Let me change the text also. Just I have now mentioned two equations. See how beautifully these expressions are, these equations are mentioned. And as I told you, in some cases you need to run 2 to 3 times to get the equation. Now suppose you want these equation numbers in bracket, you can use in the bracket also. Like this, you want those equation numbers to be in brackets, you can do like this one. Now it came. So this is how, you know, equations you can write, and equations are also, you know, not so difficult to write. Coming back to, you know, tables. So tables, we can also create tables in a very, you know, just go to here. Here you can see all the packages are mentioned. If you are preparing thesis also, you can create automatic table of contents, sectioning, environment, tabular environment. So let me begin with the table. Just wait. Okay, I will create table also. Let me check the table. Table is also not easy to create here. One table example is given, so that I was looking. Equation. Figures and tables. So see, this is the structure of table. Even if you are not compatible with the table, go to the Google and type how to create tables in LaTeX. So many contents will appear. You can copy any of the content and then you can create. So here you can see this structure. Okay. Begin center. Now how many columns you want? So here they have mentioned 4 columns. So for 4 columns, for 4 columns they have created the table. You can see 1, 2, 3, and 4. Accordingly we can create you know, tables also. Here you can see they have used this text bf command to make the content bold. So see here, text BF is to make bold. Caption is already mentioned in the first itself. So likewise, we can create tables also. So tables are also very, you know, see how well it is organized, this table. Similarly, if you want figures also, so we can call figures in the text also in any of the document. For the figure, syntax which is to be used is like this one. So you have begin figure, end figure, and then, you know, include graphics is just for a figure labeling. So here they have called the figure number 1.png. So that figure is placed here. So all you know, journals template in LaTeX is available online and even on internet. You can use, you can modify the content as per your requirement, and then slowly you will become compatible with LaTeX. One of the important thing which is you know, which creates a problem for most of the researchers, that they are not able to create references in the LaTeX. So for them, my suggestion is that first create a BIB file, and once your BIB file is ready, you can call your BIB file in the text document, and once that is available, then you can you know, run, or you can use F11 command to execute or to run or to associate your text file with the BIB file, And once it is associated, then your document will be completely and the same will be reflected as citations in your text. Now let me discuss you about the overleaf. So this is how any of the document you can create. Now if you you are not comfortable, you don't want to download LaTeX and you want to, but your requirement is to create your document in LaTeX, but you don't want to download and you don't want even to learn, then there is a solution for this type of problem. You can go to the Overleaf, overleaf.com. Please note this one, overleaf.com. In this other website, almost all journals templates are available. And that is, user friendly. So you need not to install LaTeX in your system. It is online available and templates are already available. You have to just open the template and then you can proceed like this, this is online platform. So many documents I have created using, see here, elsewhere article template is there, and then IEEE conference template is there, Springer book chapter is there, IT electronics letter template. These templates I have used to create, my papers. MDPI article template is there. So almost all, journals and articles template are there. Even thesis templates are also there. You can create your thesis, but you have to take care that since this is online, so we cannot completely trust. But according to my experience, our document is safe here, and it is not means it will not be copied. So let me tell you how we can use these platforms. So suppose you have created your account in overleaf.com and you want to create one document for elsewhere journal. So for that, what we can do, you simply open that template in the overleaf.com. So something like this, it will appear. So on the left hand side, your text file will be there, and the right hand side, that PDF version will be there. That PDF version will be there. So this is, IEEE, elsewhere article template. Now you want, you want to create your own document. So just check the PDF version where you want to change. So here, title of this particular article is Faculty Development Program. So in the left side, just check where is that Faculty Development Program is mentioned. So here title is mentioned as Faculty Development Program. What you can do, you can simply change this one. So here this is webinar. So I want to keep this title as a article title. So just compile here. So see, this is a webinar on LaTeX. Even if you want to see in the full scale, you can see. So how, you need not to spend so much of time on downloading and installing and then creating template for the journal. It is already there. Just what you have to do, you have to open the software and then you have to provide your input. Now suppose here the author's name is elsewhere, I want to keep my name here. So accordingly, I can put my name here. So see, my name is appeared here. So wherever you want to change, you can change as per your convenience. Now some may raise question that, sir, how we can add figures to this one? So let me check, is there any figure or not? Yes, one figure is there. So just check where is that figure in this document. Here is the figure. Now this instead of this figure, I want to change my own figure. So what, how we can do, because this is, you know, online document, and we have to call our figures. So just go to here, this let me take this copy only, copy 4. So name of this image is copy 4. So it is now saved here, copy 4. This you can see this one, this copy 4 is already saved. Now we can use here as copy 4. Now let us run. See, this image is already changed with the caption in the text. If you want to change its dimension, you can change the dimension also. See, its dimension is completely changed. And one thing which you have to remember always is that here I have taken JPG image. Now suppose there will be now I am calling coffee4.png, but the image is saved as JPG. It means there will be some problem. So problem you can get like this one, coffee4.jpg is not available. So it can easily, you can easily identify the problems also. Here you can see that this they are showing the problem that the image is not available. So likewise, you know, you can check, as I told you, that table creation is also very simple. So let me check where is the table in this document. Here they have created the table, begin table, as means we are forcing this table to be at this place only. Begin center means all the documents will be in the center. Now your first table, this is caption you can see here, your first table, this is the caption. Your first table, then label where we want to use in our text. Suppose we want to use here. This is shown in the table one, like as refer to table. See. Whatever is written inside this label, same has to be copied here. See here, table one, it came as a table one. So likewise, you can create now the same table which I have shown to you in my PPT. Here, the same table is represented here. Same table is represented here. So here, depending upon suppose you want to put here straight lines. So here, let me put the straight lines. Simultaneously, you can check whether it is properly reflected or not. See, now for every line you want. You want to put lines, horizontal lines also. So for every command, it is like that. You have to put S line. See, it is like that. So see, table is now arranged properly. So accordingly, we can create tables. Now coming to the most important thing, that is creation of a bibliography. So most of the students they are facing lots of problem in creating a bibliography for their document. So my suggestion is that you please all create one bib file. So here you can see that bib file is always named as .bib or saved as .bib extension. So here is the my bib file. Now these are my bibliography items I have already referred. Now I want to use one of the paper and I want to cite in this particular text. So for that procedure, let me tell you the procedure how you can directly save your bib file. So go to the Google Scholar. An example, simple example. Go to the Google Scholar, search that paper. Now, suppose I want to use this paper itself, I want to cite in my text. So, copy this one. This paper I want to cite in my article. So type the paper name, then here you can see the symbol. I just click on that one. From there you can get bib text document, EndNote, refer RefMan or RefWorks, all these are citation styles. So let me go for, since I am using LaTeX, so let me go to the bib text. So here you can get the details. Simply what you have to do, you have to copy the text and go to the bib file, paste there. Now this is the syntax. You can check key terms. So I have used this key term. Now let me go to the text. So let me now cite this to my text. So now when let me go to the document. Now I want to use here that I want to cite that paper here. So simply slash cite. Now in our this document initially we have five references. And let us see where we have DOI whenever available we have cited at this place. So let us recompile now and let us check whether it is reflected or not. Let us recompile once again. Where is that, please? And there are various bibliographic files. See, this is here reflected. This is here reflected, electrocardiogram. And this is here cited also, see. This is here cited, let me unit. Well, we have used this one, this bit. We have used this paper, electrocardiogram signal deimaging by Hilbert transform and synchronous detection. Electrocardiogram signal deimaging by Hilbert transform and synchronous detection. This is, these are the authors and it is properly cited. So this is I have considered the one case, let us consider another case also. Write any paper related to the ECG technology. So again, follow the same procedure. Select this paper. I want to cite this one. So go to BibTeX. Copy this one. Go to the bib file. Paste there. And then use the keyword. These are the keywords. Through these keywords only we use to refer these papers in our text. So here only we want to cite. So let me write. So till now we have used six papers, and accordingly we have six references. So let us now check. So see, seventh is already appeared, and seventh is actually Juicy's paper. So here you can see, and it is already available here. It is already available here. All the details. So you need not to worry about the even writing style, whether it is referencing style or MLA reference time. You need not to bother about the referencing style. It will automatically create your references in a predefined manner. So here we are using we have used the elsewhere template. That's why all the references are arranged in this style. Now suppose we want to use the IEEE, we want to create one IEEE paper. So in order to create IEEE paper, already template for IEEE is there. IEEE template is already there. So see, already there, template is already there. Suppose you want to change the abstract. So accordingly, what you have to do? Change the abstract, only abstract. Let me change this abstract. Now let me take any document for abstract. Suppose from this document we are going to extract the we have written extract like this one. This is not, you should not practice, copying. Just for reference, I am using this one. So abstract is, I want this to be as abstract. So in the abstract portion, just, type whatever you want to type. So it will be reflected here. See, it will be reflected here. Even you need not to bother about the spacing. See, here is spacing and paragraph, everything is I have not kept anything, but it is coming in a very systematic and pleasant way. See, everything is written here and it is well defined and well organized. So this is the beauty of this LaTeX. So here figures also, and you want to keep your figure, you want to put your figure. The procedure which I shared is same only. Let me now tell you once again. So if you are using Overleaf, you need not to be dependent upon the software also, and you can do online also. Only connection, internet connection is required. So let me tell you how to change the figure. So this is the figure. Now let us first upload that figure. Copy only in my system. P4.jpg. Its format is more important. Now here. person. The name of the image. Copy 4. So see, this image is there itself. You can change the size of this image also. So size of image we can change. Suppose I am completely new to this LaTeX and I don't know how to change the size of the image because it is coming, you know, it has covered a portion of the text also. So simple, very simple, go to the Google. Select how to change. LaTeX. Why I am saying, because you know, few people they will think that this is very difficult, you know, platform, we cannot work. So it is not like that. So see here, we can change the, for that one in command is they have used width is equal to 50 mm. So simply I am going to use that command in my text to change the size of that image. See that the size of that image is changed. So depending upon you know our requirement, we can change, we can enhance, and we can decrease the size of the image. See, it is now changed. Now similarly, suppose you are running this, you know, you have copied this IEEE conference paper, and you are not able to get the result because of some of the packages are missing. So for example, let me disable this package. Packages are very important. Unless you have package, it will not work. So graphics image graphics package is for figure. So I have disabled that you know package. So there is no figure. See, there is no figure. So you have to take care that all the packages, relevant packages, I mean to say that all the relevant packages are available. If available, then only your LaTeX will work. Otherwise, it will not work and you will not be getting proper output. So you can, you know, once this is created, you can take a print out of your document. Here also you can save, you can share, you can even download the PDF version. And see how beautifully it is, you know, arranged. You need not to bother about, you know, alignment, left alignment, right alignment, equation number, figure number, table number, caption. So all these things are not required, and you can download your paper from here. See that paper is downloaded. So my suggestion is that those who are completely new to the LaTeX platform, they can use this overleaf just to practice and just to create their own documents in LaTeX. It is very easy, and slowly you can learn. And if you are stuck to somewhere, then definitely take a Google help. It will solve almost all the problems. And those who are already compatible with LaTeX software, they can you know download the LaTeX software, install a particular editor, and you can proceed with the offline mode also. So that's all from my side for today's session. Let me stop here. So thank you all of you for listening to me. Now your queries and suggestions are welcome. I'll be happy to address your queries. Yes.